let me enlarge this thing first. So I use PC Tech to type this. Now, overall, you will see the past-year question is something similar to what you have. This year is also going to be like this. Yeah, we are going to have 6 questions. Definitely, the first question is going to be on the first order. Second question on second order. Third question on Laplace. Fourth question on the inverse Laplace. Fifth question will be on Fourier. And then the last question will be on PDE. So we will look into the first question first. Look at this question. Have you got this question? All right. Look at the whole question first. We have 3 parts here, A, B, and C. If you look at the question, then you realize that we need to use what you call these separable variables for part A. Part B, definitely you need to substitute something and then get a linear equation so that you can solve it. In fact, for question B, if you do not know how to change this equation into first order or second order or linear equation, you can straight away use this one to solve, because you can see that this is linear in Z. Alright? If you already got problem in changing this into this equation, you can straight away use this, because this is 8 marks. Then you look at C, we are talking about undetermined coefficient. Now look at question 1 first. A, look at this question first. This is a initial value problem. Look at this initial value problem. So who want to try this question? Who want to try this question? Anybody? Anybody? Try this question. Oh, you haven't do this, huh? I thought you have already done with this question. All right, somebody try this? Somebody try this question? Siapa nak cuba? Siapa nak cuba? Let you try this question, come. Try this question. Very simple, you just try to separate the variable first. All right, separate this variable. Don't need to bring anything, just look at the question. Try to separate the variable so that you got the X and Y portion. Alright? So you don't worry about the initial condition first. Just separate them. Come. Yeah. Come in. Okay. Dx. So what should you do now? What should you do now? So he has already tried very well, separate the variables, so y one place, x the other place. I think over the other side, the x squared minus 1 over x squared, you can do something there, right? You can just divide. And in fact, over the other side, y plus 3, y plus 2, you can also use long division so that you get some kind of term, right? Okay, try the long division, y plus 3, y plus 2. Do the long division. Y plus 3 divided by y plus 2. Use long division. That's right. Y plus 2. So what do you get? You get 1. Y plus 2. Then you should get a balance of 1. So what should you write there? You should write 1. So you be careful about this. Sometimes when you see this, you must realize this simple thing. I always write this. Okay, so what does this mean? This means 9 divided by 4 is 2 plus 1 quarter, where 1 should be the remainder. So don't look down on these small numbers. Right now, sometimes people didn't realize that that number also can be used there. Now you can see it is 1 plus 1 over y plus 2 dy. Over here you should get 1 minus 1 over x squared dx, the whole thing dx. So now you should be able to integrate both sides. Right? You should be able to integrate both sides. Okay, try. Go ahead. You should get what? Integrate 1, you should get y plus 1 over, what should you get? Ln. Ln of y plus 2 equals to integrate of 1. You should get what? You should get x, and you should also get what? X power minus 2. If you integrate the power, you have to add 1. So you get x power minus 1 divided by minus 1. So you should get plus, of course, you need a constant there. You need a constant there. Okay? So now you can put in the initial value. Y1 equals to 0. Put in the y1 equals to 0. So that you can get your C. So that you can get your C. Put in the y1 equals to 0. Rub off that one, rub off. So if you put y1 equals to 0, that means what? That means the independent variable is 1. X equals to 1 and y equals to 0. So x equals to 1, y equals to 0. Plug the thing in. So you should get what? 0 in front plus a ln of 2. Right? Ln of 2, I think. Equals to what? Equals to 1. Plus 1, I think, plus a C. So that C is actually ln of 2 minus 2. Ln of 2 minus 2. Alright, so put the C back into the equation so that you should get the final answer as, what is your final answer? Y. So be careful, this is a 6-mark question, alright? I think you should write x plus 1 over x. That should be better. Plus ln 2 minus 2. Okay? You cannot do further already because you do not need to find y in terms of x. You do not need to do that. Right? Because we are just trying to solve this initial value problem. Okay, thank you. So that is one part A. One part A. One part A. Now look at B. Look at B. What happened here? Of course, just now, I told you just now, if in case you cannot change this equation back into this, you can straight away use this. At least you get a portion, a big portion of the marks. This is an 8-marks question. Definitely the bottom portion has more marks. Right now. So if you cannot change this, of course, you can straight away use this. At least you get 4 or 5 marks there. Alright, let us try to change this equation. Now, sometimes the question will be given to you. Bernoulli equation, Laplace equation, all kinds of equation. So don't worry about this name. The one that you should pay attention to is this one. But show that by the substitution. Look at this substitution. We'll reduce equation 1 to equation 2. See that? So what you need to do now? You need to do something to this equation by using this substitution. Alright, so how should it be done? Okay, how should this be done? Now to me, I don't memorize. Okay? I told you before, I don't memorize. We normally use the usual method, our framework. Now we have z equals to y power of half. And what are we going? We are going towards dy dx. We are going towards dy dx. Now you have y, z in terms of y, you cannot do much. Definitely it should be dz dy. This is our framework. Next, what do you have? You wanted to know what is dy dx. You wanted to know what is dy dx. Of course, dy dx, I can leave it right here. See? So the balance.